Oh. Okay.
You're gonna be alright with that?
Posed.
Your reaction was great. Oh.
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 So this is Jonathan Zawada. I'm gonna talk about some of the branding stuff and stuff to do with Flume and The Difference. One of the concepts I had, or one of the first ideas I had for the video, was to do it in a split screen format. And that really came out of this idea of listening to the song and thinking about the two halves, you know, that are embedded into the music. There's sort of Harley's portion and there's Chaz's portion, and how the two things kind of marry and or coast along together. I really wanted to try to visually create a correlation with that. So the best way I could think of doing that, of having the two of them in the video at the same time, was to create this split screen system. And so the idea was that through the two split screens and throughout the whole video, they're both on either side, and they're both having these concurrent motions, but just at the last moment when the track finishes, that's when their two individual worlds completely collide and become one. And that was something that felt to me like what the music feels like throughout the process of the track. You're hearing the two parts, you know, hearing Flume and you're hearing Toro, and then as the track progresses, they really become enmeshed into this one expression. Something I really, really wanted to convey in the video was the song has this sort of propelling motion to it. I think through the rhythm and through the production especially, it sort of just has this constant feel of motion and speed, and I really wanted to try and capture that as much as possible. But at the same time, it's such a light and airy and beautiful song, and sort of so hopeful, that I didn't want it to feel like that motion was just panic, you know, that it could be some sort of imprecise version of something between feeling compelled to move, but feeling compelled to move in a good way, I suppose, but without being fully in control. And so those were some of the ideas I really wanted to explore. And then once I hit on the idea of keying in all of these other aspects and listening to the lyrics and thinking about other worlds and those sorts of things, blending those realities into the one piece, so that the two figures were running through space that was slowly dissolving and slowly disappearing as they were propelling through the environments, so that by the time they're finished, they're kind of left in this formless ether, I suppose. That was really the kind of broad idea that I wanted to try to capture. I think on paper, when I came up with the original idea, it seemed really straightforward to me. It seemed like a really easy thing to do. We'd just set up this one take. Harley would run in one direction, Chaz would run in the other direction, they'd just collide with one another. We'd have two cameras shooting them both independently. But then once I started thinking about the differences in the speed that we had to shoot them with and all the rest of it, and realized that we needed to actually shoot many different takes to try to get that to work, that became a challenge all on its own. And then my expectation of how easily I would be able to key in things after the fact and how seamlessly that whole process would work was probably a little naive. I discovered in the process that it's quite hard to do a lot of that post-work. It can become quite time consuming and can become quite detailed as well, where I had sort of just in my mind thought that it would be quite a straightforward thing. So I think those were some of the challenges that I faced. And I guess just practically as well, I think on the day of the shoot, you know, you think it's such a simple idea, just running down the street, but to actually get a length of road that's long enough to run along at a decent pace for 2.5 minutes involves eventually getting police to block off side streets and all of this sort of stuff, which definitely didn't occur to me at the start of the project. But well, they were all sort of fun little challenges and obstacles that had to be overcome along the way.